of prosperity. Showers of prosperity. That is the title I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to read from the book of Isaiah 55, verse 10 to 11. The book of Isaiah 55, verse 10 to 11. Welcome. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you. As I'm going to read from the book of Isaiah 55, verse 10 to 11, the Bible says, "For as the rain comes down, and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the heart, and make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seeds to the sower, and to bread to eater. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I send it." Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God bless your word. Father, I thank you for your word, God. I praise your word, God. I thank you, God, that the word that comes from your mouth, it will not come, it will not return void. I give you all the glory, my God. I bless you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, my God and my Father. Thank you for your word, God. Thank you, Jesus, my God and my Savior. I give you all the glory and the honor. So the Bible says, "For as the rain comes down, and the snow from heaven, and do not return there, but water the heart, and make it bring forth and bud, that it gives seed to the sower, and bread to eater. So shall my words be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall come, it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the things for which I send it." So the Lord is sending his word. The Lord is saying, as his word comes from the mouth of God, it will prosper. So you need the word of God to come to you to prosper you. The word of God has power to make you successful, to make you healthy, to make you prosper in the name of Jesus. So the Lord is saying, the way the snow comes from heaven, the way the rain come down, it doesn't go back. So when the snow comes, when the snow comes from heaven, the snow does not return to heaven. It comes down. When the rain comes from heaven, it doesn't go back. It comes down. Therefore, the word of God, it is the same. The word of God is healing. The word of God is prosperity. The word of God will work miracles in your life. So the word of God that comes from the mouth of God, it doesn't go back to God without doing what God has said it will do. So ask. The Bible says ask. In Zechariah 10 verse 1, the book of Zechariah 10 verse 1, the Bible says, "Ask rain from the Lord in the season of the spring rain from the Lord, who makes the storm clouds, and he will give them showers of rain to everyone, the vegetation in the field." So we ask the rain, we ask the showers of rain to come to your life. You ask the Lord to shower the rains of presence to fall upon you. You ask, that's what the Bible says, because his word will never avoid, will never go back to heaven. When you ask God bread, he will give you bread. He will not give you a stone. If you ask God fish, he will not give you a snake. He will give you a fish. Therefore, That what you are looking for is what you will ask God. Because God has promised us, He sent His word. The Bible says that His word can never go back to heaven without doing what He has said. If you are looking for deliverance, look for a deliverance. Ask God to deliver you. Any area you are looking for, the Lord will deliver you. If you are having problem of masturbation, some people, they have that big problem, addicted. If you have a demon of addiction of something in your life, you ask God, because God, His word, will never go heaven without doing what He wants to do. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you because your word is alive, that it doesn't come avoid. It doesn't come to you. When you send the word will do what you have said it will do. My God, I thank you for your word, God. Therefore, we ask God to rain showers of blessings to fall upon your life, to fall upon your family, to fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Showers of prosperity, showers of wealth to fall upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Ask God, because God Himself says it is His power to make you wealthy. So therefore, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. Thank you, my dear. Thank you for joining. Thank you, Deborah. Thank you, the rest of people who have joined. Thank you so much. Yes, you need these showers of prosperity. When showers of prosperity comes, you will never experience poverty in your life. Poverty is a disease. Poor is a curse. Poverty is a demon. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus, my God and my Father. I want to thank you, God, that you will deliver us from the spirit of poverty. You will deliver your people from the spirit of poverty. Demon of poverty shall not prosper in your life. Let the word of God prosper of wealth. Let wealth prosper in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that let the word of God prosper in your life to bring wealth, to bring prosperity. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. So weapon of poverty that has been formed in your life will not prosper. Let prosperity take place. Let prosperity fall upon you in Jesus' name. When you are flowing in prosperity, everything you touch, it will prosper. But when you are flowing in poverty, when you touch anything, nothing works. So I pray that let prosperity fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. You need power of prosperity. You need wealth. You need power of God to flow into your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the word of God, you see, the Bible says, as we continue reading this Psalms, this Isaiah 55 verse 10, the Bible says, it shall prosper the things of which I send it. So the Lord Almighty will prosper wealth into your life, into your family, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Your wealth will prosper, not to come and go. Some people, they can be rich today, tomorrow they have nothing. Some people, they get good money, and tomorrow nothing. They cannot be able to account for, because they are not prosper. So I pray that the power, showers of prosperity fall upon your life in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I thank you. I pray that let God arise and let His enemy be scattered. Because you see, the powers called weapon of prosperity, when it falls upon your life will never be the same again. But the powers of weapon of not prosper, when it falls upon you, you cannot succeed. You can't do anything. That's when you are faced with all circumstances. We are faced with a lot of problems. You are faced with a lot of multiple problems. But when prosper fall upon you, anything you touch, it will be turned gold. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, when you pray, the heaven will hear. As you see, we look at the book of 2 Chronicles 6, verse 27. The book of Chronicles 7, the book of Chronicles 6, verse 27. The Bible says, then hear in heaven and forgive the sins of your servants, your people Israel, when you teach them the good way in which they should walk, and grant rain upon your land, which you have given to your people as inheritance. So the heaven will hear. When prosper is in you, when you prosper, when the word of God prosper in you, the heaven will hear, and it will forgive all your sins, and the Lord will rain showers of rain to rain the land that you are. When the rain of showers of blessings, showers of prosperity rain upon you, where you are, even at the workplace, you will prosper. That is how prosper will stay. But when there is no rain of prosperity, even if you get 1 million today, tomorrow you have nothing. People get money. It doesn't mean you don't get money. You get money, you feel good, you thank God, you give your tithe and offering, but tomorrow you have nothing, you become again zero. You become again poor. Why? Because prosperity is not flowing in your blood, in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray that God Almighty will shower you with the rain of showers of blessings that does not dry. Even during the dry season, you will prosper. Because the word of God says you will prosper in the name of Jesus. Let the word of God stay in you to prosper, to bring success, to bring health, to bring good things. Because the Bible says God Almighty has good plans. Good plans to prosper you. Good plans to prosper you. Prosper is not money. It's not money. It's not only money. Prosper of everything you touch. Prosper of every good health. Prosper of success. Because the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah 29 verse 11, the Bible says that God has good plans for you to prosper you. Let's look in that scripture. Don't think that prosperity means money. It means to prosper everything you do. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. I'm going to read from the book of Jeremiah 29 verse 11. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says, God knows the plans that he has for you. He has plans to prosper you, not to harm you. He has plans to give you hope and a future. You see, let's look at that scripture. That's what I said. The Bible says, For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you expected end, to give you prosperity. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. The Lord will hear you, because he has good plans for you, the plans to prosper you, plans of good hope, plans of peace, plans of happiness. Some of the people, they are not happy. They don't know happy. They've never been happy. They don't know anything about happiness. They've been sad. They live in sadness all the rest of their life. Some of the people, once they get married, it's when the problem starts. They will never be happy. You will never see them laugh. But by the grace of God, by the showers of blessings, by the showers of prosperity, the Lord Almighty will make you happy. He has good plans for you. That's when you go to pray and he will answer you. He will answer you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord Almighty will shower you the showers of blessings, the showers of prosperity, the showers that will prosper your life, will change you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. Let's look in the book of Obadiah, the book of Obadiah 1 verse 17. The Bible says, but upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. So that upon the Mount Zion shall deliver, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession in the name of Jesus. The Obadiah clearly promised that there will be restoration of the church. There will be restoration of your finances. There will be restoration of your marriage. There will be restoration of your healing. You need this restoration in the name of Jesus. He says that Mount Zion will be holiness of holy, by which he means that God will be mindful of his covenant. God will be mindful of his covenant when he sent his word. As he said, his words will prosper. The word of God will prosper. So the Lord is concerned about his covenant, what he has said. He has said, upon Mount Zion, there will be holiness. The house of Jacob shall possess their possession. Therefore, people of God, God is concerned about his promise. He's concerned about his word that he has said. So the word of God will prosper in your life. It will never avoid. It will never change. The Lord Almighty, he knows you. He loves you so much that he concerned about what he says. He will not be like a human being to say, sorry, I forgot. So I didn't mean what I was saying. Our God, when he says his word will do what he has said. He said that snow comes from heaven and the rain comes from the heaven, but it doesn't go back. It goes down. So his word does not go back. It will do what he has promised. He promised you to prosper you. He promised you you will prosper in the name of Jesus. He promised you prosperity. So he asked, the Bible says, ask, he will give it to you. If you are looking for deliverance, he will give you deliverance. If you are addicted of some things that you cannot be able to stop by yourself, ask, the Lord will deliver you. Because he's a God of prosperity. He's a God of prosper. He will prosper you. Even that addiction, he will let it get out from your life, and your life will be different. I pray that anyone who is being addicted with something must patient. Something that he cannot stop by themselves. Let God Almighty, God of prosperity, God who will prosper you, let him come upon your life and destroy that demon that makes you to be addicted, that you cannot be able to stop by yourself. You need that deliverance, that the deliverance of God fall upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for somebody that is really having very deep financial difficulty. I pray that let prosperity fall upon you. You shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Lines of prosperity will fall upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, anyone who is been of his finances or his finances has been attacked by the demons, I release that finances in Jesus' name. Where your finances has been held by demon, by the powers of darkness, by the powers of the powers of darkness, yes, I pray that that finances be released in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty, Lord, my God, those people who their business are being gauged, have been buried, let prosper fall upon that business. Let prosperity fall upon that business. Some of you, you have ideas. You have so big ideas, but you cannot do anything. You have so much, but you are not doing anything because you need showers of prosperity. You need showers of prosper because the word says you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. You have been looking a job for many years, but your time has come now. That prosper will come to your business, to your job, to your workplace, to your position, in the name of Jesus Christ. Prosper shall fall upon your life in the name of Jesus. Some of the people, they are good. They are so good. But they have nothing. They can't do anything. The enemy has chained them. The enemy has tied their hands and feet. They are very smart. They have even good certificate. They can do something, but they cannot do anything. Years and years. The enemy is wasting your years, time, years, everything. Hallelujah. I pray that God Almighty will visit you this morning, this evening, the time in your time, that Lord will touch you to prosper you. Every power that does not want you to prosper, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 41, 10 to 14, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous hand. Behold, all who are incensed against you shall be put to a shame and confounded. Those who strive against you shall be as nothing and shall perish. You shall seek those who contend with you, but you shall not find them. Those who wage war against you shall be as nothing at all. For I, the Lord, your God, hold your right hand. It is I who says to you, fear not, I am the one who helps you. Fear not, you one, Jacob, men of Israel. I am the one who helps you, declare the Lord, your Redeemer, is Holy One of Israel. So God is telling you, do not fear. He will help you. Even if you are not prospering right now, don't fear. You will prosper. Don't fear of anything. The enemy has made you to suffer. The enemy has gauged you. The enemy has tied you. You are answered that you cannot do anything. But the Bible says, do not fear. The Lord has released you. The chains has been cut. Isaiah 41, 10 to 14. Isaiah 41, 10 to 14. The Bible says, fear not. Even the situation you are facing now, do not fear. For I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. The Lord is promised, like the way he promised you in the book of Isaiah 55. As he promised, a big promise, and they sent his word, that he's saying, don't fear. Don't fear. The Lord will raise you up. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will give you prosperity. The wealth of the Gentiles will be transferred to you. Your life will change as long as you don't stay in one place that you are crying, you fear, you don't know, you get confused. The Bible, the God is telling you, don't fear. Don't fear. Do not fear. Because fear is the enemy. It's a tormenting. It's tormentment. When you live in fear, you cannot prosper. Come out from that fear. The Lord is opening doors and windows of heaven. The Lord is opening windows of heaven to prosper you. The Lord is opening windows of heaven to prosper you in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord Almighty will visit you in a special way that will take away the spirit of fear. You might be going through some stuff, but the Bible is telling you, don't fear. He has promised you will prosper. This word will prosper in you. Restoration is coming back. The Lord Almighty is not a liar to lie. That's why he gave you promise. He promised you, he gave you example, like the snow comes from heaven, like the rain comes from heaven, down. It doesn't go back. So his word will prosper in your life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The Lord will prosper, his word will prosper in your life. things that is not working for you, but the Lord will make it to work for you. It is your time. You have been crying enough. But the time has come now that God Almighty will reign, will bring showers of blessings, showers of prosperity to fall upon your life in Jesus' name. I want to thank God for so much that God is able to shower you the showers of blessing, the showers of prosperity that he has promised, that his word will never come, will never go back to heaven without doing what God has said. I pray that God will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God Almighty, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, will see you through in Jesus' name. I pray all your blessings transfer, all your blessings that has been transferred through evil manipulation in the dreams, I command them to be restored in seven times in Jesus' name. All your blessings that has been, hallelujah, I don't speak, yes. Yes, my God, I thank you, Father. I pray that God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray all your prosperity, all your blessings that has been gated by the devil, I pray that God will release them in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, my God, I pray that God Almighty will see you through in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let God restore you. Let God restore everything that you have lost in the name of Jesus. My God, I thank you, Jesus. Lord, I bless your name. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I thank you. I pray that God Almighty, let your people, Lord my Father, as your people trust you, believe you, have faith on you, God my Father, prosper them, God. Let prosperity fall upon them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you. I give you all the glory, God. I give you all the honor, my Father. I pray, God, my Lord, I destroy and bind every demon that is holding your people captivity, every demon of poverty. I destroy them in Jesus' name. Every power that is pursuing you with poverty, let them destroyed in Jesus' name. Every power that is taking good things from you, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. I thank God because God is able to deliver you from the hands of the enemy. My God and my Father, I thank you. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. I have to stop here. God is good. So I will come tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Saturday, 8 o'clock. Sunday, 8 o'clock. So 8 o'clock every Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 8 o'clock. Tomorrow I will be on 8 o'clock. Sunday, 8 o'clock. So I'm trying to avoid the midnight prayer. And I will come on when we have something. But for now, I will be doing for 4 days. That is Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. But if I come anytime, I don't know the time I will see me coming. But the time that I want to be on for now for a few days, I will be on Thursday, 8 o'clock. Friday, 8 o'clock a.m. and Saturday, Sunday. Thank you very much for joining. Thank you. Welcome. Invite your followers. Thank you very much. God bless you. And remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. We have our email. This is our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. The email is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. The email is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. We have our phone number to call us. If you need prayers, if you need somebody to stand with you, to agree with you, You can always reach us. Our number, my sister, you can pull it out. Our number is 877-241-3420, extension 101. And we have direct number. If you don't want to go to extension, you can call us this direct number, 905-487-7196. 905-487-7196. God bless you so much and have a wonderful time. Remember, my birthday is coming, 20th of May. And you can participate